Now to the latest on the desperate search for that missing college student in Iowa. Mollie Tibbetts vanished more than 2 weeks ago. Now her family is speaking out, raising the reward for her safe return. We will hear from her boyfriend in just a moment. But first, ABC's Alex Perez is in Brooklyn, Iowa, with the latest on this case. Good morning, Alex.
Good morning, Cecilia. This is a small town, tight knit, and just about everywhere you look, you see posters like this one with Mollie's picture. People here are desperate for answers, and they're hoping this increased reward will get someone to come forward.
More than 2 weeks after she disappeared during a jog, Mollie Tibbetts' family begging for help.
We believe that Mollie is still alive, and if someone has abducted her, we are pleading with you to please release her.
The police have remained tight-lipped about the investigation, and the family says they understand why.
They are not sharing information with us because they don't need to share information with someone who might be implicated in this.
Tibbetts was last seen going for a jog in this sleepy Iowa town on July 18th. The 20-year-old was spending the summer at her boyfriend Dalton Jack's apartment. Jack, who is not considered a suspect, was over 100 miles away working a construction job the day Tibbetts disappeared. The two were planning to leave for the Dominican Republic yesterday for his brother's wedding. Last week, her mother telling ABC News that wedding meant the world to Tibbetts.
I'm thinking of that August 2nd deadline where I want to get that little girl and Dalton and Blake and Allie on a plane and, you know, go enjoy yourselves in the Dominican. I can't stand that these people are having a wedding and she's supposed to be the maid of honor.
Jack's brother reportedly suggesting he proposed to Tibbetts, his high school sweetheart, at the ceremony, which has now been postponed. The investigation is ongoing, with authorities focusing on her Fitbit, which could help pinpoint her movements.
Authorities say they have received about 200 tips that they are following up on, and they have about 40 investigators working on this case every day. Cecilia?
Okay, Alex, thank you. And joining us now is Mollie's boyfriend, Dalton Jack. Dalton, we have all been following every word of this story. We certainly are thinking about you and Mollie's family. We heard Mollie's mom say that she believes Mollie is alive but may have been abducted. What do you think happened?
You know, I'm not really putting a whole lot of speculation on what happened. I'm putting that in the hands of the authorities to let them figure it out.
You know her best among those who know her best. Is there any chance in your mind that you think she could have left on her own?
No.
Not at all?
No.
You were the last person to hear from her. It was a Snapchat message. Did it give you any clues about what could have happened to her?
No, it was just a standard message, picture of her face and a caption that, you know, didn't really mean a whole lot because we were just talking back and forth on Snapchat and I don't even remember what the caption said, to be honest with you.
You were working 100 miles away when Mollie went missing, and we all know investigators have ruled you out as a suspect. Can you walk us through the last night that you heard from Mollie?
That would have been Wednesday night before she went jogging. We were just having conversations on and off through text and Snapchat, and that was about all. It seemed like a totally normal night.
It seemed like a totally normal night, and then she went on a run, right? Walk us through what you know about those final moments that we heard or saw her.
I don't know a whole lot. The investigators are keeping pretty tight-lipped for good reason, you know, to not compromise the investigation by putting anything out there that doesn't need to be out there.
Dalton, when people are watching and hearing you right now, you must have a message for them. Anyone who might have any idea where Mollie is, what would you want to say to them right now? What do they need to know at this moment?
Well, obviously call the tip line in. Just try to put yourself in our shoes. What if somebody had taken somebody that you love so much and just have the courage to come forward and give the information to the police? And again, you can call Crime Stoppers and they will put it forward to them and it'll be completely anonymous. So there's no really need to keep that to yourself.
Mollie's family had a message for anyone who may have been her abductor. Do you?
Just everybody has a Mollie, a person that has changed your life in such a huge way, and that's in everybody's lives. Just imagine if somebody had taken your Mollie. Put yourself in our shoes. You would do anything to get her back, and you would just be desperate for anything to come forward to get her back.
Well, we are thinking of you. We are thinking of Molly. Our thoughts and prayers are certainly with you. Dalton, thank you.
Thank you.
You know, those clues are coming in, but this just remains a complete mystery here. And to hear the family and Dalton say that you would do anything to get her back, they are not giving up hope. Yeah, but this is a tough case.
And just 1,500 people in Brooklyn, Iowa, so devastated the community all coming together. All right, thank you.